is myself Amar. In this video I will discuss about Maven-Archetype. Okay, so in the previous videos I have discussed that if you are using Maven, then it is not required to know the project structure, it is not required to know what jar files are required, what dependencies are required, because everything will be taken care by the Maven. Okay, now in Maven, Archetype is nothing but a plugin which contains a number of predefined project templates, right? Now, whenever we run the Maven-Archetype command, then the Maven will automatically create the folder structure based on the project template. Okay, let me show you. MVN, I am writing MVN. What I have done in the desktop, I have created a folder with the name Maven, and now I am running this command MVN-Archetype colon generate. This command is used to create the project structure based on the template. Now, whenever we press enter, at that time what the Maven will do, it will download all the files from the central Maven repository where all the project templates are present. Okay, and after that it will be stored in a local machine. Generally it is stored inside C users name M2. Okay, all the files will be downloaded in our local machine inside this particular folder, which is called as the local repository. Okay, next time onwards, whenever we are issuing any Maven command, then first of all it will search in the local repository, and if the corresponding jars or plugins is not found, then it will go to the Maven central repository online and it will download all the files in this local repository, right? Now in my case, I have already downloaded all the files. If you are running this command for the first time, then it will download the required files from the central repository and it will download it to the local repository, right? Let me run this command. I'll wait for a while. Just wait, it is working in the background. If you are running it for the first case, then it will download all the corresponding files, all the archetypes from the central repository. In my case, I have already downloaded. It contains a number of predefined project templates, right? And all this list which is coming in the command prompt is nothing but the project template's name. See, all these project templates has been listed here, and each and every project template contains a unique number, right? See, all these are the project templates identified by a number. Like if you want to create a simple J2E application, then we can use this number 1078, right? Now here if you go, then by default it is given the number as 1085. You can change this number based on your requirement. I am choosing the default one. Press enter. Now it is asking me to choose a version number. Let it be default, that is 6. Define value for property group ID. What is this group ID? This group ID uniquely identifies your application. It means you can consider it like a package name which contains a number of classes, right? Similarly, group ID contains a unique name. Inside this group ID, it will contain a number of artifacts, right? The group ID, as I told you that the group ID is similar to package name. This means it must follow the package convention name, okay? I am giving the package name as com.ripplescode. Let it be Maven demo. Okay, press enter. Now it is asking for the artifact ID. Artifact ID means if you are creating a desktop application, then jar file will be created. If it is a web-based application, then var or EAR file will be created. What will be the name of the var file? What will be the name of the EAR file that is identified with this artifact ID? Right here, I am giving the name as Maven demo. Okay, enter. Now define the value property, let it be default, and define the value property for the package, let it be default. Okay, it is asking for the confirmation, let it be Y. Now see, once you press I, you will see that in the desktop I have created the structure Maven folder. Inside this, this folder is created automatically, which contains src file, and inside the src file we have main and test. Okay, this test contains the unit testing code, JUnit test, right? And this main file contains our Java code. This main file contains our Java code. Okay, and one more file is created, which is an XML file, which is called as a form, that is project object model. It is an XML file which contains the configuration details of our Maven project. See, whatever information we have specified, that is group ID, artifact ID, version and packaging, all these. Packaging means what kind of applications we are creating. If it is a desktop, it will be a jar. If it is a web-based application, it will be EAR or WAR file, right? All these informations are stored inside this XML file, as well as it contains the dependency. This means, as I told you, that when we have created this project, then the unit testing, JUnit testing code is also written there. And to do the testing, our dependency is required, JUnit jar file is required. Okay, now whatever dependency or whatever jar file is required, that is written inside the dependency section. Okay, in my case, the JUnit with the version 3.8.1 is required, and whenever we will build this project, then the corresponding JUnit library or jar file will be loaded from the Maven repository into our local repository, right? Now, once we have created the project structure, after that we need to compile. To compile, we will write mvn compile. Okay. Now, whenever you will issue this command, the corresponding jar files or the corresponding files required will be downloaded from the Maven repository. In my case, I have already downloaded, that's why it will take from the local repository, right? Now, here it is generating some error. What it is? Oh, I need to move to the directory which contains the POM file. My POM file is inside the Maven demo. We will move to that directory. Now I will issue the command mvn compile. Enter. Now it is compiled. Yes, it is compiled. Now I need to create the corresponding jar file. This means I need to package it. And to package, what we will do, I will write mvn package. It will automatically package. Means it will produce the corresponding jar file. See, if you are seeing building jar, it has created the jar file inside the target folder. You can see here, Maven demo target folder. Inside the target folder, this jar file is created. Now I need to run this. Very easy. We will move to the target folder because it is present inside the target folder. Then we will write java-cp in the name of the jar file, and after that the name of the class which we want to execute, that is com.ripplescode.mavendemo, because it, the class is present inside this package. Dot, the class name is app. Okay, press enter and see, it is producing the output hello world. Okay, this is how we can create a project structure using Maven. Okay, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.